Well, up first, let's focus on the latest vaccine news and Covaxin, the homegrown coronavirus vaccine that was authorized for use in January before full clinical trial data was available, has been declared safe, immunogenic, with no serious side effects by Lancet that has published its phase 2 results, which means that finally the phase 2 results have been peer-reviewed and published in a leading medical journal. Lancet has said that efficacy cannot, however, be determined by the phase 2 trials, but the vaccine made by Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech is safe and immunogenic. The Lancet report says the results reported in the study of phase 2 results do not permit efficacy assessments and further corroboration with phase 3 safety results is required. Remember a couple of days ago, in fact, Bharat Biotech itself released interim data on its phase 3 trials that claimed the efficacy was 81%. However, no data has been published for peer review yet. However, now you can see in Lancet, at least the phase 2 study has been published. Well, to talk more about what this means, we're joined by Dr. Anita Ramesh Chandra, a specialist in clinical trials. Thank you so much, Dr. Chandra, for joining us again. So take us through the Lancet findings. So now they have corroborated the findings or peer-reviewed the findings of the phase 2 trials of Covaxin.
Yes, it's a very landmark study. Remember one thing, that Lancet is one of the very high impact factor journal in the world. And anything which comes in Lancet has a huge value. Now, let's go back a little bit and tell what is phase 1 and phase 2. So in Covaxin, as we know, it's a Hyderabad-based vaccine by Bharat Biotech, which has completed the 3 phases. But the results of phase 1 as well as phase 2 is only what got published in Lancet, which got released yesterday. So phase 1 means that it does on a, just to see the safety and the antibody titer, they looked into a couple of hundreds of cases, and it was seen when they did the phase 1 study, it was safe. Phase 2, they also did the phase 2. They did, in Covaxin, what it is, the whole vaccine is inactivated entire virus. It's an entire viron. It's called EV. And this entire viron has been subjected to phase 2 study to see the what dose it can be used. So in that Lancet study, what it released, there was a 3 microgram dose and a 6 microgram dose. And this inactivated viron was put on a vehicle, or you call alum, that is aluminium hydroxide. That will just help you to get inside the body. So it was seen that the 6 microgram was safe. There was no adverse reaction.
Right.
And the safety portion was there's no any serious adverse reaction. Mild reaction with any vaccine is something common. It's going to happen. So, and in also, they also showed that the first 3 months, the sustained titer of the antibody was seen in the blood of these patients.
Right.
And the study concluded saying that.
Right. But at the same time, we're still awaiting the phase 3 trial data. And, you know, at the time that the vaccine received the emergency use authorization, many around the world were actually shocked that India would go ahead. While it's a huge achievement, of course, this is our homegrown vaccine. However, unnecessarily, don't you feel that a cloud, came over this with the rush sort of allowing of it to be used, the emergency use authorization? Even now, we're still awaiting those phase 3 trial data. However, even if they announced in the interim, they announced interim data, and that was also just a publicity announcement, a media announcement. They didn't actually publish the data of the phase 3 trials yet. So this is something that so far has not been seen in the world, that you go ahead with, you know, millions being vaccinated without the phase 3 trial data in place.
Yeah, the thing is that there's 2 issues. The phase 3 trial data, I agree, Covaxin had an emergency approval because we need something at that point of time. And it's not that the vaccine has not been tested. When the emergency approval it got in the month of January, more than 22,500 people were tested. The target was 25,800. They were only short of 3,000 people. So when they presented the data to DCGI, it was seen that no death or serious adverse reaction took place. And yes, government that has the right to give approval to drugs and vaccine on an emergency use, seeing because we are in a pandemic situation, we need to get something. And that's why it has been given. Now, if you see the Lancet yesterday's paper, which got released, it says that this confirms that safely you can go ahead and do the phase 3. That itself is quite, gratifying, and quite gives us a lot of strength to say, yes, the vaccine is safe. and let's move on. And we know already not yet, publication has not happened. And remember, publication takes time. To publish the results of a data, as we in oncology, we anything to get published, minimum 2 months, 3 months. It takes particularly a journal like Lancet, but I know the process is speeding up. I'm sure results lately, shortly rather, but the phase three data, which is also available in public domain, that there is 81% efficacy with this co-vaccine, not much of side effects because
right. So we know that it's safe. So it's just the efficacy right now that we don't know for sure. We only have that interim data that claims it's 81%.
Yes, that's we don't know. But we know it is a safe vaccine. The data says it's highly, rather they quote, it is more efficacious than the COVID. And another important thing of this this particular vaccine is they have used the entire viron inactivated. So you can use for patients in allergy safely. So use for any mutant strain which is coming, because the whole virus is producing the antibody. It's not a part of the virus like, say, mRNA or viral vector. So it has two big advantage. Yes, you are right. I agree with all the viewers. Phase three data is needed. But at times of emergency, you can have an emergency approval because this is life-saving.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Chandra, for joining us. And hopefully we will have that data soon. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Now, the other issue we're discussing today, after statements by Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan and Delhi Health Minister Satyendra Jain about nearing the end of the pandemic and how we're in the end game of the pandemic, and now it's going to turn from a pandemic to an endemic disease. The Indian Medical Association, however, has cautioned politicians and the government about invoking a false sense of security. The IMA has urged fellow citizens to be vigilant about wearing masks and physical distancing, so warning everyone to, you know, continue taking care despite the fact that ministers are claiming that perhaps we're seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. Well, to talk more about this, we're joined by Dr. Jayesh Lele, Secretary General of the IMA, and Dr. Sarman Singh, Director AIMS Bhopal and Senior Virologist. Dr. Jayesh Lele, first to you about this warning, if you could tell us more. And some would just say that, you know, the ministers and the Union Health Minister are trying to, you know, give a note of optimism to the people to, you know, hold on. There is the light at the end of the tunnel. The pandemic is coming to an end.
Yeah, I think so. At this moment of time, we are definitely not all that clear when the pandemic will end, number one. Number two, the vaccination, we are approaching very fast through our private sector, private hospitals, and increased vaccination. The second dose also, most of the healthcare workers have taken, senior citizens are taking. At the same time, there are some miscreants that they are not following the rules and regulation of this game, wherein the social distancing, masking, they are not protecting. So just saying such statement that it should not land up all these people in the problem, because you have seen that last 1 month, 6 to 7 states, the increased number of cases across India also, the number of cases have increased. What we saw in the month of Jan-Feb, now this March, it has already increased. And we are sure definitely that this social distancing, the people are very quite, they will get important that, the minister is declaring that we should not follow this. Vaccination is there. But you know very well that vaccination results are still, even if the vaccine has been taken, somebody can infect other. So we have to follow social distancing. We have to be very cautious. And such statement, still time to come to the stage that the pandemic is there. So I feel that it is a little premature statement at this moment of time, I can say that.
All right. Dr. Sarman Singh, your view of the statement that was made by the ministers, and then, of course, the warning from the IMA that, you know, please don't let your guard down at this point.
Yeah, I think the last phrase you used, I would, you know, without going this side or that side, I would say that definitely the time has not yet come that we should, you know, lower our guards, and we should continue with the masking and the physical distancing and all appropriate behaviors, including the, not gathering in the, you know, crowds and all these kinds of things. The issue is that, you know, whether it is ending right now or not, I would not like to comment anything on that either side. But definitely the corona is still there. and till the from all countries it is vanishes, we cannot say it has ended. So probably, I don't know in what context our honorable minister said, but definitely
he did say the end game is near, but we must, you know, follow the science. We must ensure that our near and dear ones get vaccinated. But of course, the headline remains that, you know, the health minister says the end game of the pandemic is near. And at the same time, Dr. Singh, we're in the midst of elections right now. So while all of you can say continue with your social distancing and mask wearing, we're seeing visuals all over our media of these huge crowds gathering, you know, each party trying to outdo the other with huge crowds gathering with no sort of protocols in place. So what would you say about that when it comes to messaging right now?
Yeah, definitely. I don't know, the media sometimes, you know, the TRP plays very important role. I'm not sure that, you know, in what context he said, but definitely I'm sure that he himself is a doctor and he's a well-meaning minister. He didn't mean that, you know, we should lower our guard and there is no need of mask and there is no need of any precautions. He has been saying, and I am sure that vaccine, maybe in what context he said, but definitely I want to, and I have been saying whenever, you know, I am on the any, you know, platform here.
Okay, let me
I have
put
been
that
saying,
question.
Dr. Lele, what he is saying, that we should not, you know, relax any, and there is no time to be, you know, complacent. No complacency.
All right. Dr. Lele, to you, that question regarding, you know, these visuals on the media of all the massive campaigns, and you've had big campaign, BJP campaign in Kolkata. You have Mamata Banerjee holding a big campaign in the south, in Tamil Nadu, big campaigns and large gatherings. So there's a lot of mixed messaging going around from our political leadership.
Yeah, I think so. This kind of mass gatherings, and we can see in that mass gathering in your visuals, hardly anybody is using the mask. And, you know, you will come to know the effect of this after 15 days. And definitely, if you recollected the incidents which occurred in the US, that one Negro was had violence was there, and after violence, such a entire America, the cases increased. And so I agree with Dr. Sir that definitely we have to be very, very careful, and let us understand that, see, another most important thing is our crowding and population is there in India. You go to any small village and small place and small town, the crowd is there. So, I mean, the social distancing, if you allow this to happen and if you increase the disease after 15 days, whom to blame for this purpose? Vaccination, still it is not gone to peak. We have not achieved the herd immunity. Still a lot of time is there to get herd immunity. So we should be very slow. Yes, vaccination we increase all private sectors, we increase all small hospitals where can be given. So intensity will increase naturally. To get herd immunity, it is going to take some more time. So this kind of a crowd without a masking is very bad.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us on this topic. Thank you so much, Dr. Sarman Singh and Dr. Lele. Do stay on for our viewer question segment. Well, let's now take a look at some questions posed by our viewers. Let's listen into that first question and Dr. Lele will answer that question.
My question is, what are the chances a person shall contract the virus even after getting two doses of the vaccine? Essentially, because there were some cases reported of people contracting the virus even after getting the vaccine.
Right, Dr.
See, this
Lele.
Is a...
Yes, go ahead.
This depends on the strain, what you are carrying, how virulent it is. And especially, as you mentioned, that without two doses of vaccine and without having any mask and this thing, there are chances definitely... when you have met the person concerned who has suffered from the disease, how infective he is, what day you have met him, and what kind of a contact you have used to nearby. So all that will depend on that. So that is why I see that on that, in the beginning, when we have discussed that contact of, say, 4 to 5 hours, the virus remains on the utility, on the paper, even right in the beginning when we are exchanging the clothes, exchanging the, you know, utensils or anything. So we have to be very careful. And slowly now, after the newer research and study, we have come to know that at least 4 to 5 hours the vaccine can remain live. So you have to be very careful, avoid the contact. And that's why again, I must say that wash hands repeatedly, avoid social distancing, at least 1 meter away from the person concerned. And especially if you, the person may use a shield also in that case, suppose there is a more gathering. So these three things will give you more protection without the vaccine.
All right. Well, let's listen into the next question.
My question is that with the rollout of the two Indian vaccines, the Covaxin and the Covishield, the ambiguity around their safety and effectiveness has created various myths about them. According to your expert opinion, are these vaccines safe enough to be administered? And if given a choice, which one should we choose?
Okay, Dr. Lele.
See, right now you have already seen that. See, the Covaxin and Covishield, they are derived from a different kind of a process. But at the same time, what is the immunity level? What is the antibodies you are going to get? So right now, Covishield was made available in India, across India. Most of the centers, the Covishield results are very much available. What we see day in and out that I have got a report that many doctor friends who took on the first day, took the second dose after the exactly 1 month, and after 15 days, there was a variation of antibodies. So ultimately, this is an immunological response. So that it will go from the immunology person to person, how much antibody is developing. So at this moment, I would say that Covaxin and Covishield are equally effective. Covaxin, some results are awaited. Covishield, good results have come. Immunity has definitely shown to be increased after 6 weeks of after that doses of vaccination. So I would say that even if you get a Covaxin, you can take it. There is no harm. You will get the immunity because first and two trials have been successful in the case of Covaxin. And with the third phase also being available within a short time, you will definitely get both the vaccines in a good immunity purpose and good antibody will be developing.
All right. So basically just get vaccinated. Don't worry about which one you're getting. Thank you so much, Dr. Lele, for answering those questions for us. Well, time for us to slip into a short break. On the other side, we'll take a look at India's vaccine drive. Welcome back. Well, let's now take a look at the vaccine numbers and let's just pull up those numbers for you. Here, let's take a look at the vaccine tracker. And India has vaccinated now 2.3 crore people so far. So 2.3 crore doses of vaccine have been administered. In fact, yesterday we hit a record 20 lakh vaccination. So a huge number there with 20 lakh being vaccinated yesterday. So that's a huge number that we managed to hit yesterday. But the number still has to increase to at least, that's 2 million. So it has to increase to at least 5 million per day for us to actually reach that target that we have of vaccinating 30 crore people by the summer, by July and August. And this is how it stacks up. If we take a look at the vaccines worldwide, the United States leading there. They vaccinated 90.35 million people so far, and followed by China that has vaccinated 52.52 million, and European Union has vaccinated 40.67 million so far. And if we just take a look at those numbers, and India here with a total of 23.01, this is the number till 8th of March, that 23 million people have been vaccinated in India so far. United Kingdom, 23.34 million being vaccinated so far. So let's just take a look at that tracker. And today the new cases, 15,388 cases were reported in the last 24 hours. Now this is a lower, a slight dip that we've seen in the daily cases today, given that for the last 3 days, we've seen over 18,000 cases being reported every day. So we've seen a slight dip there. And if we take a look at the active cases, now this is important as well. You can see active cases, it's gone down 0.7%. It's gone down there slightly. Let's also take a look at the deaths. And deaths are currently at 1,57,930 deaths have taken place due to coronavirus. Now, the positivity rate is something that's very important for us to see because this tells us about the number of tests and the number of people testing positive compared to the total number of tests taking place. And as you can see, it has been going up slightly. It was 4 weeks ago 1.7%, and now it is at 2.4%. So the positivity rate has gone up in the last couple of weeks. So that is something that's slightly worrying. And remember, we're seeing a surge in at least six states where we're seeing the maximum number of cases being reported. Well, and finally, here's a warning for all of you to continue to be careful and following all those COVID protocols. Bollywood actor Ranbir Kapoor has tested positive for COVID. His mother, Neetu Kapoor, confirmed this on Instagram. She wrote a post, "Thank you for your concern and your good wishes. Ranbir tested positive for COVID. He is on medication and recovering well. He's self-quarantined at home and following all precautions. So a cautionary tale there. Do remember to continue following all those protocols. Well, that's all the time we had on the show today. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.